Welcome to Sanjana's Education Strategies. Learn the trade secrets to cover vast concepts in no time. If you like the video, please do like, share and subscribe.
Now, we are going to see about state of equilibrium. So, first you should understand what is this state of equilibrium. Okay, when there is a body. Okay, I am taking a ball. A ball is placed in a table. Okay, ball is placed in a table. When no forces are acting on the ball, ball, and it produces no change in its state of rest or of linear or rotational motion. Now this ball is in rest. Okay, so there is no change in its state of rest. Why? Because no forces are acting. Okay, some bodies they will be in linear motion. Okay, so even that, no change in their linear motion, because no other, first of all, when I'm applying a force, this ball starts to move. When it is in a linear or rotational motion, that time no force is being applied. Okay, then you can say it is in dynamic equilibrium. Understood? Okay, so no change in its state of rest or of linear or rotational motion, then the body is said to be in a state of equilibrium. Two types of equilibrium we are having. One is static equilibrium, another one is dynamic equilibrium. Static equilibrium means when the body remains at rest. No forces applied, the body is at rest, it will remain in rest itself. Okay. Dynamic equilibrium means the body remains in motion. No external forces applied. Okay. So, it will be in motion itself, but no forces will be applied. Now, definition for static equilibrium, when body remains in a state of rest, under the influence of several forces, the body is in a static equilibrium. Okay. Next, dynamic equilibrium, when a body remains in the state of motion, let it be translational or rotational motion, under the influence of several forces, then the body is said to be in dynamic equilibrium. Now we'll see some examples for static equilibrium and dynamic equilibrium. So these are examples. First two are examples for static equilibrium. Book lying on a table. Okay, now just see this. Okay, there is a table. Okay, there is a table. And in this table, we are keeping a book. Okay, imagine this as a book, a pile of book. Okay, so this book remains in rest itself. Okay, and it has weight. The weight of the book will be acting downwards, and there will be a normal force which is acting upwards, or you can call it as a force of reaction exerted by the table on the book. The table exerts a force of reaction on the book which is upwards. Okay, so it is balanced. Both are balanced, so it is in equilibrium state. Understood. Next example is a beam balance. You know how a beam balance is placed? Like this. Okay, a beam balance, you will be having two sides, it will be connected. So in one side you will be keeping some weights. Okay, in the other side also you will be keeping some weights. Okay, so it will be balanced. If both the weights are equal, if W1 and W2 are equal, then you can say they are in equilibrium. They are in equilibrium, static equilibrium. That is, they are not moving, they are at rest itself. Okay, next is example for, that's all example for static equilibrium. Next is example for dynamic equilibrium. You are considering a raindrop and stone tied at the end of a string. First we'll see raindrop. So when you consider rain, okay, from the clouds, from the sky, rain will be falling. Okay, raindrops are falling and they reach the ground surface. Okay, so these raindrops, initially they'll be moving with constant velocity. Velocity, speed. Okay, constant velocity. Now, the weight of each raindrop's weight, okay, the weight of each falling drop is balanced by the sum of buoyant force and force due to friction. Buoyant force is force exerted by the air. Understood? So, this buoyant force and the force due to friction, or frictional force. Frictional force. The sum of buoyant force and frictional force is balancing the weight of the raindrop. Okay, so what happens? The net force will be zero. Net force will be zero. So you can see it is in dynamic motion. No change in motion because it is moving at constant velocity. These raindrops reach the ground with that constant velocity itself. Okay, next example is stone tied at the end of a string. And there is a stone. Okay, imagine this is a stone. Okay, it is tied at the end of a string. Okay, now this string is held by a person. Now, when this person is rolling this thread, that time the stone also will move in a circular path. Yes or what? So, for that circular path, it is moving in uniform speed, Sims. Why? Because this string, we are using a string. String has tension in it. This tensional force is offering centripetal force. This tensional force is offering centripetal force for the circular motion of the stone. Understood? For the stone to move in a circular path, we need centripetal force. So who is offering that? Tensional force of string is offering this centripetal force. Now we'll see the conditions for equilibrium. Now we saw what is equilibrium. Now the conditions for equilibrium. The resultant of all forces acting on the body should be zero. The resultant of all forces acting on the body should be zero. And the algebraic sum of moments of all forces. Algebraic sum of moments of all forces acting on the body about the point of rotation also should be zero. Two things should be zero. One is the resultant of all forces acting on the body. Another one is the algebraic sum of moments of all forces acting on the body about the point of rotation should be zero. Now we'll learn what is. So actually this one, no? The second point, the second condition of equilibrium, it is called as principle of moments. It's known as principle of moments. Okay, so you have to write according to principle of moments. State principle of moments, will get a question. So according to principle of moments, the algebraic sum of moments of all forces acting on the body about the point of rotation should be zero. Now what is principle of moment means? The sum of anti-clockwise moment should be equal to the sum of clockwise moment. That is only principle of moment. Now to define principle of moment, there is a small example, so you can just listen to this example carefully. Understood? So here imagine there is a meter scale. Okay, there is a meter scale. So randomly I'm just marking the scale. Okay, this is a meter scale. Okay, now in the two ends, one is A, another one is B. In two ends, I'm using a spring, okay? And what I'm doing is, I'm carrying a weight. Both the end, I'm just putting a weight, okay? Using a spring, okay? Say, one weight is W1, another one weight is W2. Okay, so this is W1 and the one is W2. Clear? Yes. Now this scale should be balanced. This weight should be balanced. So pivoted point is kept in each place. So using a rigid support, using this, in this region, I'm going to balance this. This is the pivoted point. Imagine this is the pivoted point. Say O. Pivoted point is O. So at this, see, it doesn't mean that pivoted point should be in the exact center, because both weights will be different. If the weights are same in the center, if you keep, it will balance. But since the weights are different, what happens? You should search in which pivoted point. You have to place in each point and see in which pivoted point both the weights remain in equilibrium. Understood? Yes. Now in this pivoted point, in this position, both the weights are equal, in equilibrium. Now from O to A, the distance is taken as L1. From O to B, the distance is taken as L2. Now listen carefully, children. This W1, okay, the W1 first weight, in which direction will it move? In clockwise direction. in clockwise direction. In this direction it moves. W2 weight, it will be moving in anti-clockwise direction, that is in this direction. Okay, it will be moving in this direction, it will be moving in this direction. Okay, this is what you have to understand from this. Okay, yes. So now clockwise moment of weight 1, it is W1 into L1. Now anti-clockwise moment of weight 2, it is W2 into L2. Sorry children, this is L1, okay. This length only we are taking. This length and this weight, okay. And this weight and this length, okay. So meaning, if W1 and W2 are equal, then it is said to be in equilibrium. Meaning, W1 into L1 is equal to W2 into L2. Okay, W1 weight, moment of force, if it is equal to W2 weight, moment of force, W1 into L1 is equal to W2 into L2. So this is known as what? The principle of moments. This is known as the principle of moments. Very important, children. Okay, very important. Now, that's all about this topic, about the principle of moments. So, I hope you understood this topic a lot. And another one important thing, principle of moments, usually main example we learn is beam balance. Another name for beam balance is physical balance. Okay, so yeah, now we understood about the verification of principle of moments, which we saw now, about the verification of principle of moments. Okay. And I hope you understood this video a lot. If you have any doubt in this video, please you can show it in your comments. And if you like this video, please do like, share and subscribe. Thank you so much.